Okay, do you, what's going on?
It's Jess.
That was good, yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, Jess, that was good, though, man.
You are an effing bastard, dude.
I know.
Yeah, I just tell you that. Lucky. You're lucky to have a friend like me.
You talk too much, though. Don't talk as much.
I know, but I'm trying to, like, I'm a little drunk, so that's part of it.
Yeah, that's
okay.
Fine. Whatever.
It
doesn't matter.
This is bringing stuff out, I think. I think we can do a good job, like, following the interesting course
line.
Definitely.
I appreciate it.
So you know some of the people, right? Are you familiar with the girls at all?
Vaguely. I know. I've seen them twice.
You know their names to the face? Like, Mara?
No, I think.
Laura's the one with, like, the orange shirt?
Yeah, with the slits in the back?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay.
The bra one today.
Right, yeah.
Okay, and then Lindsay? Blonde,
yeah.
Then Phoebe?
Phoebe, yeah. Yeah, I know who she is.
Okay. So, fuck, marry, kill. Mara, Lindsay, Phoebe.
Huh. It was Mara, Lindsay, and who?
Phoebe.
Yeah.
Phoebe was the, dark hair ponytail today. Yellow shirt.
Fuck her. Kill Mara. Marry Lindsay. Or
okay.
Phoebe, rather.
Okay.
Yeah.
I'm sorry, what was it?
Wait. Yeah. Kill Mara. Fuck Lindsay. Marry Phoebe.
Okay. Do you need to change it up?
Can you see me?
What would you change about the production?
Well, my personal, coming into this without knowing really what the hell's going on, I would change the fact that I would like to have some time to prepare rather than just getting thrown a script and having to, you know, jump up and, you know, basically read it for the first time as I'm reading it, you know? So I guess just more scripts and maybe a script in advance, maybe a PDF file, something you can read through. So, because my character does a lot of monologuing, so you kind of need to break that up into moments and beats and whatnot, and it's difficult to do that on the fly. So I would change that. Other than that, I think it's a very interesting and yeah, just very interesting setup. I've never done anything quite like this, so yeah.
What do you feel about? Would you know if I said religion? What? How do you feel about religion?
Oh, I'm an ardent atheist. I don't believe in God to the point where it's an extreme for me. But I understand religion as a necessity for some people. I put my faith in what's tangible and what's provable. Yeah. It's a really touchy subject for a lot of people. I find it fascinating, and like my three deities are Richard Dawkins, Stephen Fry, and Christopher Hitchens. So I think organized religion has done the most, the best and the worst things humanity has ever accomplished. So yeah, that's where I'm at. I'm an evolutionist.
All right. I'm reckoning that's based on your character, eh?
Well, my character is he's very evangelical, but yeah, so it's quite opposite of who I am. Yeah.
Can you understand his point of view, his perspective?
Yeah, absolutely I can. I think the moment you can't understand where someone's coming from, you shouldn't act as them. I think that you're doing that the writers or that character a disservice. I can absolutely understand where he's coming from. I can't understand the extremes, I can understand them. I just don't like them, but I, you know, I can understand where he's coming from what I've been, from what I've seen so far. I've only seen, you know, 4 episodes, so for all I know, he could be a complete douchebag and I not know about it.
Right on, okay, fair enough, fair enough.
Okay, give me everyone. Okay, how about, this is kind of weird. So, can you give an example of a superhero or villain? Oh, here you go. Give everyone a superhero or villain power on the cast. So I'll walk you through this. Let's start with the girls that we started with. How about, let's start with Mara. What superhero or villain power would you give her?
Well, she seems really nice. So I would say, animal, like, control with animals. Yeah. Little cute animals and stuff.
I think you said that about any of the girls. That's a good one. Lindsay? The blonde one?
Let's give her flight.
Flight, not bad. Phoebe?
I'm thinking like a lady death, what the hell's her name? Deathstriker? Like very limber, very like Captain what's her name from Iron Man 2. Can't remember the name specifically, but like militant, but like at the same time very aggressive type of thing, you know, like very flexible and able to like kick ass.
She'd be like the colonel.
Yeah, something
to like any superhero really, telling
yeah,
working with them.
Something like that, yeah.
Right, not bad. Terry, the I haven't interviewed you today. She might maybe wear a dress.
Yeah, I saw that, yeah.
Terry.
Yeah.
Oh there. Oh, okay.
Terry.
Oh, okay. The fuck?
Alright, I'm sorry. Do you know him? Do you know this guy?
Me?
Yeah.
No.
Oh, okay.
Ian was the one who brought me into this.
Oh, all right, right on. Oh, yeah, right. You were in Romeo and Juliet with him, right?
Yes, yes.
So you don't know Terry, though?
No, I don't really know anybody else besides Ian.
Okay, okay. Terry was also in a play with him. I didn't see Romeo and Juliet. I heard it was good, though. I do apologize for that.
He was good in it. It was not that good a show.
Really?
Yeah, no. Not in the slightest.
Play?
I was Abraham, I bite my thumb at you, sir. It was the first show I did at that new theater, so in every new theater you go to, you have to climb up the hierarchy.
Sure, yeah, you know. Absolutely.
So.
They have their, especially, it was, out in Wheaton or something, too, right?
Batavia, but
Batavia,
yeah.
Batavia,
right. Yeah.
It's a small town. They have their fanzines, right?
Exactly, they
That's
have cool. their core set. I live in Naperville.
Oh, okay. Right.
Yeah.
So you you come out of quite a way for this.
Yeah. I mean, it's fun. I mean, I drive twice as far. I love filming and hanging out with actors and just, you know.
This is kind of cool, yeah. For me, just as an outsider, this is a good idea. Ian is he's the man.
Yeah.
Well, let's start with Ian then. How about what superhero or villain power would you give him? And remember, he's more the villain.
Yeah, with the bald head, I'm thinking Bullseye, but no, I'm thinking more what was his name? Sinister, if you're familiar with him. He was, Sinister. He was the one that brought forth the mutant gene. I'm a geek, but I don't have comic books. I just read up on the shit online. Dr. Sinister, Professor Sinister, or whatever. He was back in the 1800s. He's a badass. And he kind of reminds me of being in kind of controlling puppets and things like that.
That's a good answer, man. I'm not even letting you off with the rest of these questions, but I don't think I can. Okay, so we're on Terry.
Terry, right.
Yeah.
Yeah. I'm going to give her, like, She-Hulk abilities. Like, don't piss her off. And then she turns green and, like, clothes rip and she throws cars and shit.
Okay, let's see, who else is there? I thought with the dudes. How about Gary?
Gary, well, you get the whole Peter Parker thing from him, at least I do anyway. So I'll give him Spider-Man.
Nice, not bad. Should be happy to hear that. There's also Josh.
Josh, yes. He's like a scrapper, so I'd put him like, I don't know. Let's just give him Wolverine. Why not? Because he's kind of small, but you know, Wolverine in real in the comic books is like 5'3".
Oh really?
Yeah. So.
And Scott the guy.
Is he the one with the camera?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, I really have no idea. Let's give him Colossus.
Colossus, nice. Am I missing anyone? How about yourself?
I've always had a Hulk complex. I've never gotten into an actual fight in my life because I'm kind of scared. Because I'm a very big guy, and I could really hurt somebody. So I'm yeah, either the Hulk or Colossus. Yeah.
So you look nice, but you get the rage.
No, it's more like you don't want to see me when I get pissed off. So I've extreme self control. Like, you know, I've been in jail before, and I've hung out with, you know, gang members and shit like that, but I've never had to, you know, I've always stopped confrontations with my mouth or by just showing that it was a bad idea for that person to do whatever it was that they were doing.
So right on, yeah.
Never had
don't
to
don't fight. They either something to
exactly.
Yeah, it gets a lot of trouble.
Yeah.
Cool, man. Good answers, I gotta say.
Alright, we done?
No, we have two more.
Okay. Rock.
Alright, so here's what I apologize for earlier. What's your deepest secret?
My deepest secret? Yeah, probably when I went to jail for 2 months. I don't tell people that, obviously.
Remember, you're on a, you know, this could be edited for...
Yeah.
That's cool, okay.
Hey, you asked the question.
Yeah, absolutely. But, you know, like, this is my first time, so I'm...
Yeah,
okay.
Yeah. I think it's basically that. It takes a long time. That and my mental problems. I'm bipolar, I'm insomniac, I have ADD, I have major depression disorder. You should see my cabinet full of medicines. It's probably those two things that I don't spring on people. You know, it takes a little while for me to, you know, build up trust that they won't freak out when I tell them the truth about what, you know, who I am, I guess.
Do you want to explain the jail comment?
This was before I was diagnosed bipolar. I was in a manic phase, which is basically riding high, and it... I'm very susceptible to outside influence, and a couple people and I, we broke into two subways and a church, and yeah, it was kind of fucked up. Looking back on it, it reminded me a lot of the Joker from The Dark Knight, you know, just wildly shooting and just doing shit like that, because if I had a gun, I probably would have been doing the same thing, because I wasn't medicated properly, and I had